Hey everyone, Kelsey here and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm excited to share with you this awesome and revolutionary new update to rotoscoping inside of After Effects. It's called the Roto Brush 2.0, which allows you to easily cut out the foreground from the background using very complex scenes. So if your subject is moving and the camera's moving and you don't have a green screen, this new Roto Brush 2 uses Adobe Sensei machine learning to be able to predict the movements of the foreground so you can easily cut it out and it's not very monotonous, laborious work anymore. So before we jump in to show you how the Roto Brush 2.0 works, let's give you some background on what rotoscoping is. So rotoscoping was originally developed by animators to trace over live action to actually make real animation seem more authentic to real life. So they would trace frame by frame to actually create better animations. But now rotoscoping is used in software to add visual effects and animation to live action. So rotoscoping can be used to replace or completely change the background, add text behind a subject, which is a really cool effect to do, which I'll show you briefly at the end of the video how I did that. Or you can actually add animation and trace on top of the foreground, or you can replace and mute certain colors on the foreground. And a lot of this is used in lots of cool music video effects. And with rotoscoping, you can add all sorts of visual effects to the background, or you can add groups of people and replicate it to make it look like there's a bigger crowd. So there's really so much that you can do with rotoscoping. Now, before we jump into the tutorial, I want to give a big thanks to Vamify for sponsoring and helping support the channel. Vamify has tons of amazing cinematic effects, including LUTs, film overlays, and lots of sound effects. Their sound effects pack called Krypton has over 300 cinematic sounds that will allow you to build a very complex, big budget sound design for your next film. And you can use my code GAL15 to get 15% off this pack. So here's a preview of some of the sounds from the pack. What I love about Vamify, it's not a subscription model. You just have to purchase any of the packs once and you can use it forever. So with these sounds, you just download it, you can import it inside of the project panel and just drag and drop the sounds into your timeline to build out your sound design. Now I've done videos on other packs from Vamify. You can check out my seamless transitions tutorial and you can use my code GAL10 to get 10% off that pack as well. So I encourage you guys to check out Vamify. I've put a link in the description with the discount codes if you want to explore it further. And now let's go ahead and jump in and check out the amazing effects of this new Roto Brush 2.0. All right, so for this video clip, we're going to play some really cool, colorful visual background effects behind the dancers using the Roto Brush tool. First, let's double click on the footage to open it up as a new layer window, and then choose a frame where the subjects are fully in view to begin rotoscoping. Then select the Roto Brush tool, and then you can begin to just draw over the subject to select it. And the best part is you don't have to trace the edges. Just select any part of the subject and Roto Brush will then auto detect its outline. If Roto Brush selects part of the image that you don't want selected, just hold the Alt or the Option key and click to remove it. To add to the selection, just click and drag again. And once the subjects are selected, hit play and Roto Brush 2 will then analyze the subject's movements from frame to frame. If you find any mistakes in the selection, you can use the Roto Brush tool and hold Alt again to remove the mistaken selection. So once the selection is good, you can go back to the composition panel. And then from the effect controls, you can refine the moving cutouts using motion blur and decontaminate edge colors. And this will make sure that the cutouts are as perfect as possible for the composition. And then you can place your visual effects or background textures behind the cutouts as layers. Be sure to duplicate the original video clip and turn off the Roto Brush effect to preserve the original background. And then you can place the effects between. I was also able to create some other really cool effects. I used the Roto Brush tool to quickly roto out this runner and add text behind her. And after I used the roto tool, what I did was I duplicated the video layer and I turned off the roto effect on the bottom layer to preserve the background. Then I created a text layer and placed the text between the two clip layers so the text would be behind the runner. And this could be a really cool technique for opening credits, and the possibilities are endless. I saw that Learn How to Edit Stuff YouTube channel showed how to place a text message behind a person on a treadmill. So there's lots of different tutorials to get inspiration from. And one quick tip, if you are sending a clip from Premiere Pro to After Effects for rotoscoping, and you want to preserve the transparency, you can just save the clip in After Effects after you rotoscope it, then go back to Premiere Pro, and from the wrench tool, you can turn off the transparency grid, and you'll see that it has a transparent background from which you can add backgrounds using just Premiere Pro.
So that's all for an introduction to the Rotobrush 2.0. If you guys want more rotoscoping tutorials that goes more in depth on how to create visual effects, like longer form tutorials, just give this video a like. If it reaches 5,000 likes, then I know for sure you guys want more rotoscoping tutorials on the channel. And now this brings me to the comment of the week. Tech Velour wrote, can you export the caption file and add it to your YouTube video? This was left on my previous video on the new captioning update in Premiere Pro. And yes, you can export the captions as a .srt file. And that's one of the best parts about this new update is that you can generate your transcript, you can export the captions, and you can have your captioning file ready to go right before you publish. And that's exactly how I use this tool. So if you haven't seen that video, go check it out. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Hey, how's it going? Oh, you guys should check out my keyboard here. It's Editor's Keys, and it has my Gal logo on it. They made it custom for me, which is really cool. It's a backlit Premiere Pro shortcut keyboard. And I recently had it in storage and I just opened it up because I just finally got my desktop set up. I've been like working off of my living room floor for a while now, but now I have this up and I'm super stoked about it. So,
Pa.